it's so important to see folks like Jonathan and Geneva doing the work that they're doing.
I'm Douglas Jefferson, Senior Vice President of National African American Gun Association. I'm here with Geneva and Jonathan out here at Redstone in Burbank, California.
Township, let's go. Salute to the hustle, getting stacks and bundles. It's not the good trouble, but the profit it doubles. The streets are real dangerous, sharp enough they'll cut you. The odds are in my favor, no sound from the muzzle. Yeah, Captain and the Queen, Redstone is the shit. Carbine magazine loaded 5.56. Gotta grind, gotta build black businesses. Got a squad for the job and they coming equipped. Yeah, diversify funds, turn the property value. My eyes stay focused, can't fuck with no scoundrels. Go and get your money, keep stacking and counting. Flipping and bouncing like we do with the ounces. Yeah, international hustler, gonna stamp my passport. Take off instantly, G5 or G4. Traveling man, always on my square. It's all about how you move, asymmetrical warfare. Hey, man.
They are working in, you know, some of the least friendly conditions to the Second Amendment that exist in this country, and yet they are thriving. And part of the reason that they're thriving is because of just their hard work, their dedication, and how much they care about the community getting this information.
We have two classes today. One class today, two tomorrow.
Two tomorrow. So essentially, Jerry, let me show you. This is everything we had to do yesterday. So, and each one is full, and that's Friday, that's Saturday, Monday, we have two classes.
There's one day that is not full yet.
I need to have to add Wednesday next week, and then we go to Friday, and then we go Saturday. So it's crowded.
But they're also thriving because the community's been so starved of this information, so starved of this access for decades. And they're literally the only outlet that's there to do it. And thank God they are there to do it.
Hit us up on that number below and we'll get you taken care of.
This is Redstone Firearms in Burbank. Reaction to this monumental ruling has been strong and swift.
Quick question, did the Supreme Court decision motivate you in any way for the SCCW?
Absolutely.
You mind if I ask some of you guys, did the Supreme Court case have anything to do with you guys getting your CCWs?
Yeah, absolutely. So I purchased my first firearm from this establishment about a month ago. I'd been planning on it, but once the ruling came out, I booked as soon as I saw Jonathan's post. So
it made me rush to come faster, and just to get in line first. I believe it's gonna be a bunch of people trying to get in on this. I just want to get it first.
Yeah, actually, it did. Well, more so, the on-time prompt information from Jonathan is what actually sealed the deal. I was getting into the tub instead of waiting on the right now yesterday morning. And the classes were sold out.
For those who have not seen the news just yet, the Supreme Court did come back with a ruling in the favor of those who are 2A, or pro-2A, I should say. Basically, really long story short, what has happened now is the Supreme Court has said you do have a constitutional right to self-protection outside of your home. Yes, law enforcement or the entities that be can request or require a permit, but you no longer have to be a may issue. Everyone will now be a shall issue.
Is that a lot of the laws that they put in place affect people that they believe they're protecting? They talk a lot about addressing gun violence, gang violence, but the things that they're putting in place actually harm people who are responsible firearm owners. And it's not the rich, white firearm owner they're hurting. They're actually hurting the middle class. They're hurting people who look like me. And they're preventing us from being able to protect ourselves, especially women of domestic violence, where you have to wait 10 days. Well, that could cost you your life. as a woman of, you know, victim of domestic violence. The concealed carry laws can cost you your life here in California if you're a victim of domestic violence or a victim of violence, period. And so a lot of times they spend a lot of time putting legislation out there that disarm Black people, thinking that it keeps us safe when realistically it doesn't, because here at Redstone Firearms, we don't see many gangbangers and criminals and people who want to rob people here to buy firearms. They're not coming here to do that. The people that are coming here are responsible firearm owners who want to know the laws, who want to do this responsibly, and they're affecting that demographic and, you know, not punishing the other.
Being able to protect myself and my family and my loved ones and my property and my community is the utmost importance to me. Because if you have a stable family and a safe home, you have a safe street. If you have a safe street, you have a safe community. You have a safe community, you have a safe neighborhood. If you have a safe neighborhood, you have a safe region. It all trickles down. And I believe by having firearms, it's a positive thing. How you engage with people, that's another thing. But if you are a law-abiding citizen, then 99% of us are. We just want to protect our families, protect our property, and live our lives. That's a value add.
So this front door area is where the entrance will actually be. But as you see where the lines are, this is going to outline the wall that's going to be here. You guys are actually standing in our new classroom. Okay. So this would be technology-filled classroom for gun safety for all types of people. From just a regular basics class to our concealed weapons classes and so on, our child safety class and so be it.
I'm really, really hopeful for the future when it comes to firearms ownership within the African-American community. We've had a historic win coming out of the Supreme Court with the New York State Rifle and Pistol Association versus Bruin ruling that has struck down those unconstitutional may issue carry permit regimes. I mean, to tell you how happy I am about that is an understatement. We've literally had individuals that have contacted NAGA, members that have contacted NAGA and spoken of how they have been denied permitting under these regimes. And these are people that have no criminal history. They are good citizens. And many of them even had documented instances where they have either had been victimized by a violent criminal, or they had been threatened with harm, documented threats of harm from violent criminals and violent actors, and yet they were still denied those rights. You know, if the Second Amendment isn't there to help you with deal with those type of things, then I don't even know what it's there for.
I think it's going to be the future of CCWs here in LA County.
I think CCWs are definitely going to go up. I know among my friends, all of them have considered it, but it's kind of daunting, kind of undergoing it, and so at least from what I've heard, it's almost impossible to get it in LA. Moving forward, I think with the new Supreme Court rulings, I think it's going to get easier, hopefully, and I think more people will apply.
And to see that finally it's been recognized that that has to change, you know, I'm very excited. You know, it opens up a whole new opportunity for us to reach African Americans that, you know, wouldn't have or, you know, haven't pursued exercising those Second Amendment rights because they just knew that they were going to be denied them anyways. Now we're in a brand new day, and I'm excited to see what comes out of it.
But for all you guys that keep shooting the wrong target, that house, that boat, that car you just bought, guess what? It goes away. Pay attention to your target. Because if you shoot and kill someone that is an innocent bystander, guess what's going to happen? Who are they going to come after?
Mm-hmm. Murder. Shoot your gun, I'll make you a believer. Now you better pray for something more.
What is this thing called? You know what that's called?
This is the trigger right there.
That trigger, rule number one, keep your finger off the trigger. If you find a gun somewhere, if you see a gun somewhere, of course you definitely want to say something to somebody. But you also want to make sure that if by any chance you have to move it or do anything to it, you never put this finger on the trigger. This is your best safety. Best safety in the world is the safety of your body.
I'm so proud to know Geneva and Jonathan. They are a jewel in the industry, in the black community, in the firearms industry. They're doing it real time. They're buying land. They're buying a gun range. They have a gun store. They're doing it. They're showing us how it should be done. They're helping thousands and thousands of African Americans across this country by selling products to them, giving them hope, giving them empowerment. They are somebody that I've watched. They kind of started the same time I started, and we've kind of grown together. Geneva and Jonathan have always spoken well about the organization. They have spoke representing the organization at the Washington, at the gun rights Senate hearings. So I'm very, very proud to know them. They're my brothers and my sisters and sister, and they do the right thing. They go about their business the right way, and they have, I think, the kind of moxie, the kind of mindset that you need to have as a firearm owner and producer of a company and a store. Redstone is the shit.